my God.
No, I literally can't do this.
People are out there?
I'm not doing it. I'm not doing
no,
it.
Joe, we have anxiety.
I can't even make a phone call.
No, like, there was a phone in front of a room, and now we're getting in front of 350 people.
No, this was supposed to...
This is buck nuts.
This was supposed to stay on the internet. This is insane to me.
I can't believe we're doing it.
Are our mics on?
Our mics are on.
Hello?
What the fuck? Oh, my God.
I guess we just have to do it.
Tom, play the video.
People of planet Earth, I'm Joe.
I'm Andrew.
And this is I, Joe, where we give you our own little web shows.
We do stuff like polls,
funny videos
that you can send in,
and even the best of the rest.
Andrew, do you have any ideas?
Well, I don't know, Joe.
What do you have to say about it?
Me?
Yes.
You know? No. You tell me. You don't know?
No.
Without further ado, we're introducing, stay with me, Tom and Jeff.
I'm in Rome with my best friend. I'm good. You made one.
Okay.
Seen such a beautiful night. I could almost kiss the stars, they're shining so bright. When I see you smiling, I go, oh, oh, oh. I would never want to miss this. 'Cause in my heart, I know what this is. Hey now, hey now. This is what dreams are made of. Hey now, hey now. This is what dreams are made of. I've got somewhere I belong. I've got somebody to love. This is what dreams are made of.
Holy shit!
No, I'm having a panic attack.
See you in this next one!
No. We'll give it to Hillary. Floor. Yes, Maggie Ziegler!
This is what dreams are made of. Hey now, this is what dreams
I'm out of breath.
Are made of. I've got somewhere I belong. I've got somebody to love. This is what dreams are made of.
No, I can't breathe.
Okay, we gotta cut it.
Oh my God. We're shortening it.
We're almost done. Woo!
Yesterday my life was duller. Now everything's technicolor.
Oh my God.
Hey now, this is what dreams are made of.
How do we get out?
Hey now, this is what dreams are made of. I've got somewhere I belong. I've got somebody to love. This is what dreams. This is what dreams are made.
Everyone, we gotta do the haze.
Hey, 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 hey. Hey, hey. This is what dreams.
Hey, hey,
this
hey,
is
hey.
What dreams. What dreams are made of.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Holy. Oh wait. My God. Guys.
Stop.
No.
Why are you standing?
Literally no.
Don't stand up. Don't stand.
Oh my God.
Stop standing up.
Stop. Oh my God. Is this how Meghan Trainor feels?
No, yeah.
Holy shit. I can't
you guys,
imagine.
Welcome to the M train. Like we're
actually
here.
We took a train right here.
Oh my God.
Oh my gosh.
We like performatively were like we're gonna be out of breath after, but like
no, it's like so embarrassing. I'm a fitness
breathe.
Coach. That's my job. I'm here.
Oh
like,
my God.
Fire me.
Wait. Oh today has been, I would say, like first of all, hi, hi everyone.
Hi.
How's it going?
Oh my God.
Welcome to the Bell House.
Oh my God, I bet you didn't think that we were going to come into that song. And in these tuxedos.
You, I bet you they did.
No, they
I kind of feel like we set a precedent.
Oh my God.
this has been one of the most challenging days of my entire life.
Yeah.
Like,
not to be hyperbolic at
no,
all.
No, I've never been in my entire life. Can you explain the journey of getting this here to everyone? Because
this?
I feel like it's worth noting.
Okay, so like I actually almost risked my actual job for this. So let me explain the last 24 hours for you. So yesterday we're like, how the hell are we getting this damn love seat to the Bell House?
First of all, this is not the couch.
This is not the couch. I fully ordered this on Wayfair. And... if you work for Wayfair, no, you literally don't because it's a 30-day return policy.
And we are wanted for fraud.
Okay, so I said to Joe, like, Joe, what the hell? What do? We have to get a freaking love seat. So, like, now what? He was like, okay.
I have the perfect plan. I'm like, listen. And again, if you work for Wayfair, please, please, cover
your ears. We're outing ourselves.
Because this is bad.
I'm like, Joe,
I was like, I've heard from a friend of a friend that the best thing you can do is buy furniture from Wayfair and then like report it as damaged and then you get it for free.
So I'm reporting it as damaged. I'm like, Joe, where the fuck is the picture? Like, I need the picture. He's like, give me 2 minutes. He comes back. He edits a little rip in the side. I send it to Wayfair and they're like, that's not real. So now we own this love seat. It's really great. It's really comfortable. But yeah, we had no way of getting this love seat to this venue. So yesterday, Joe you want to explain how you were?
My physical
Your
self?
Your physical state?
I would say in the past 48 hours, I have been through like every ailment someone can go through. I would say all of it was caused from stress and exhaustion, like which I didn't know was a real thing that like people actually have. Like I was like, Rita Ora goes to the hospital for exhaustion, but I was like, I should go to the hospital for exhaustion. Like it got so scary.
He was under maybe 5 different blankets.
It totally
I go
did
into
five.
His room and I'm like, Joe, are you good? We have a show tomorrow. Like perk up.
It like conveniently synced up with like all of our last minute tasks. So I was like, Andrew, I'm so sorry, but like I can't get out of bed. Like you have to really bear the weight of it all and get it done. But you've
like,
got it done.
You literally texted me up in the bathroom. It's like a novel. I'm like, oh, he's mad. He's mad at me. He's like, this is what you need to do. I'm like, okay, I literally got it. So I'm running around Brooklyn. I'm like, okay, first of all, I need to get a task rabbit because I can't bring this couch to the Bell House. So I'm on the phone.
At one point, you were renting a U-Haul and you were
I was
were
renting a
it.
U-Haul. I was like, shit, I have to go to Woodside, Queens, pick up the U-Haul, drive it all the way to the Bell House to Kiwanis. I don't even know how to get there. How did you guys get here? Because
clap for everyone who got here tonight.
Yeah,
that's
like,
a huge
for you
deal.
Guys. You made it to Kiwanis.
I really am really proud of every single one of us.
Yeah,
like,
it's really,
we made it.
It's really incredible. But anyways, I got the task rabbit. I'm on the phone with Jonathan. I'm walking around Williamsburg, picking up all of our little giveaways, whatever. I finally get the task rabbit. Today I go into work. And that's fine. Joe's sprawled out. You're sprawled out.
I was healing at this point.
Yeah, he was
healing.
Mentally and physically, and I was also, I guess, healing. But I walk into work this morning, and they go, Andrew, you didn't show up yesterday to your shift. And I go, oh, my God. I was like, you don't understand. I had a day yesterday. I was talking to a task rabbit, and I honestly think that's enough.
You had to make me pastina.
I was making Joe pastina. I was like, you can't get up.
I'm
like,
upon my list, which was like, again, like, figure out how to get the couch here, like, orchestrate giveaway gifts. One was like, please make me pastina.
Are you getting my notifications? I'm like, oh my God. I was like,
I was laying in bed, speech to texting, which I've never done in my entire life. I'm a big voice noter, but speech to text is a different beast. I could not lift my head to type. I was saying, and pastina, please. And then I heard you like bouncing around the kitchen, and I was like, he's on his phone and he's not addressing my 85 texts.
Yeah, I did have about 15 messages from you. Yeah. I don't know why my notifications
and
were
on. And I was like, some were urgent. Some were urgent. Yeah, the pastina was very urgent, and we did get it, thank God.
Oh my God, but we made it here, and that's all that matters. And now I'm sitting on this little couch, and we're in front of you, which is crazy.
No, I literally can't even like possibly process what's going on in front of us right now. Like, you guys know that for the past only 6 weeks.
We keep saying it's only been 6 weeks.
Long endeavor.
It's only been 6 weeks.
But actually for the past like 6.5 months, we have just been sitting in our living room, literally on this chair, technically on that couch, like just recording ourselves like on our phones and then posting it to the internet. We have never heard people laugh at us.
Yeah,
like
ever.
This is the first time that we're hearing that.
Yeah.
Like it's a crazy.
It's crazy. It means a lot.
Stop. It's surreal.
It really is surreal.
And to be in the Bell House of all places, also like we have that. I don't know if you've listened to the podcast, which maybe some of you do. we told the story there, but I feel like it's worth telling again in this room. That literally April of last year, Good Children wasn't even a concept yet. It was April 19th, to be specific. And we were in this room, standing room only, in the back. I'm so sorry to everyone who's standing. But
no, like you, I would also want to stand so I could leave at some point. I'm sure I would also be like, stand up and walk out the door.
We were here for Alana Glazer, who fellow Long Island icon, like queen, the moment, yeah. And me and Andrew, full of delusion as we always are, we're like, we could do this. We were like, this
like,
makes
I turned
sense
to Joe,
for
I'm
us.
Like, what the fuck are we doing?
Yeah. Why are
I'm
we
like,
not doing
where
this?
Do I work? What do I do? I was like, I want to be on this. And I'm like, all it took was her being from Long Island.
And
I
we
was
were like, we
done.
Can do it too.
Done. All right. If she can do it, we could do it, Joe.
And we got in an Uber home. And in that Uber, we were like, podcast. Let's just do it. Like, buy a microphone. Let's do it. The following day, 4:20, we bought those microphones. We
that's it.
Created our set, and we did Good Children. And it was like with the intent of performing here. So it's really so surreal to me that we are here in this moment. Like, it cannot... Wild.
Really wild.
And now looking at you in this moment, like, we've been talking about this, obviously, for, like, months on end, but,
what
like...
What were you going to say about me?
I'm like, you really could have... Yeah, put some more work in.
I should have.
No, but like just seeing, like again, it's like a real dreams to reality moment. Like not to get spiritual in the moment, but like it actually is insane to me.
Truly, and you look great in a tuxedo, Joe.
And so do you.
Oh my God,
we
really did come out here like we're like this is gonna be our Vegas residency. Like we're showing up in tuxedos, like we are the next Ben and Jerry, like we are doing this thing.
Actually, no, we're the next Ben and Jerry. We're the next Tom and Jerry.
Tom and Jerry, for sure.
That's really accurate. Frog and Toad.
Frog and Toad?
Yeah. Siegfried and Roy.
Yeah, that one.
And we know have, like which one of us is gonna have the lion attack.
For sure, me.
Yeah.
For, I mean, like, I'm dead.
It's too soon.
It's way too soon.
But yeah, we wanted to bring you guys into that Vegas moment, which is why we went to a tuxedo rental place across the street from us.
And I honestly, I have some traumatic experiences at tuxedo rental places.
Oh my God, wait.
And
yeah,
I do want to discuss it.
I like forgot about this.
Yeah, no, it started probably when I was 8 years old. And I was getting ready for my communion and I'm going with my mom to the tuxedo rental place.
It was...
And
VIP Tux.
It was
name and shame.
Absolutely VIP Tux.
Broadway Massapequa.
Now they're shut down. We understand why. So I go into the tuxedo rental place. I'm definitely like looking like an Italian meatball as I do. And I walk right in that door and the guy sizes me up and he goes, no, we don't have the size for you here.
No, like.
And my mom said, you go outside for a second. I'll take care of it. She came out, Carol was in there, and she was smacking that guy around.
No,
she walked
yeah.
out that door. I still didn't get a tuxedo, but I got Listen, I felt good. My mom had my back on that one, but yeah.
It was not only that for you, though, right? It got worse?
I would say, like, it maybe, like, got progressively worse, but, like, maybe better. It depends on the way that you look at it. It kind of depends on the way that you look at it, but I was getting fitted for my brother's wedding, and the woman took her hand, slapped my stomach, and goes, okay, slimmy. I go...
I'm like, okay, is that a compliment? Or, like, what are you saying, slimmy?
I'm like, why are you slapping my stomach?
To this day, my sister only refers to you as Slimmy.
Slimmy, I know.
He is Slimmy in the Hedges household.
She really
does. It changed lives. Like, say what you want to say about her. Like, she was a trendsetter.
She was a trendsetter, and now I go by it. But yeah, those were my traumatic tuxedo stories. This one wasn't as traumatic. We did just walk.
It was really easy. Really? It was actually, no, it's traumatic in a new sense for us, which is, like, we need every person who ever meets us to fall in love with us.
It's so, the people-pleasing tendency.
It's so sick. Like, we went to this tuxedo place. We were like, we need to make these girls actually buy a ticket to the show before we leave.
We just have a live show, so she's like, oh, cool.
You're like, we have a podcast. It's about trauma, but it's funny. And they ultimately, did they bite?
They didn't. No, they didn't bite. They said, get the hell out of here. What do you want? It's going to be this much money. And I said, okay. I was like, let's use this card, not this one.
Oh, and then
I don't know.
The declinings happened.
Yeah, no, like, listen, like, we don't need to talk about my card's declining. Listen, that's why I'm here.
It was a mutual decline, though, in that moment.
It was a mutual... No, it was only a mutual decline because, like, you were standing in solidarity with me in that moment. Being like, no, like, my card's also getting declined. And I'm like, okay, that makes me feel so much better.
I had to impress them. I couldn't let them... Like, it couldn't be one or the other. I was like, yeah, like, my zip code is wrong, but I will tell them that I also am maxed out of my credit card. Which, like, on a normal day, I am. It was kind of rare.
Yeah,
I was like,
really
wait,
rare.
I'm fucking rich. This is the moment.
Literally, Joe ordered the Uber to get here because my Uber, do you know, is anybody in the Uber Elite member here? Because I am, and I...
Not for long. This is the last time it happens.
Exactly. So I've taken two Ubers lately, and since I'm an Uber Elite member, they're like, listen, like, if your car's not going through, don't worry about it. Just pay it in a week. And I'm like... If anyone here works for Uber as well, Uber Wayfair, we're going out in handcuffs.
Yeah, no.
We're done.
Oh, easily.
This is done
I
for.
Knew we would leave this venue in handcuffs.
Yeah,
like, one way or the other.
One way or the other.
We're going to prison.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, yeah, but so now you're in debt to Uber and
in
then
debt
to
Uber
credit cards.
And to Wayfair and to, I don't even know, like, I was printing out things today, too. They were like, no. I was like, what?
No, I can't. I can't. This is humiliation. Oh, my God. We have a list of things to talk about, and, like, I've been trying to find a natural way to grab it. And
grab
I
the book.
Yet.
I
but I'm like,
never
why are we
do
pretending?
Like, you like, see the edited version of us, guys, and sometimes we're not that quick. I do want to know who is in the room tonight.
Oh, right.
For sure. So first off, we are going to start with our honor society, the Good Children.
Oh, yeah. Are there
society.
Any Good Children honor students here?
Oh my
yes,
God.
Queen.
Oh, my God. Okay.
So for those who don't know, we have like a group chat of like extreme Good Children listeners who we rely upon every time we record because we have no short-term or long-term memory. So
it's
we're like,
really tough.
Have we talked about like gym class before? And then we get like 50 messages immediately in response. We're like, great, we did that like episode one. Like we can move on. But yeah, I love those queenies. Like
we're
they
so
have saved my life multiple times.
Okay, the next people, if you know us personally in real life, give it a round of applause.
No, Rachel,
like,
no, we need to impress everyone else more.
Nobody knows us in this room. That's actually crazy.
We're gonna
sold out the house not knowing anybody in this single.
That's crazy.
Room.
Yeah, wait. Wow, good for us.
Good
we
for
really
us.
Pulled in a house.
No, welcome guys. And clap if you are just a listener of the pod. Oh my God. That's crazy.
Okay, also, and be honest, like,
please.
Be brave.
This is
say
all that
what
honesty,
you want to say.
Obviously, please.
Like, if you are here, like, as a friend of a friend, like, you've never listened to the podcast, you don't know who we are, like, you're just, like, one of those. I'm seeing claps.
Yes,
I'm seeing claps.
Please clap.
Okay, what's your name? Nicholas. Okay, so Nicholas hates us. Nicholas hates our guts.
What are these two gay men doing on stage?
And the thing is, like, I will now spend the rest of the show making sure that Nicholas leaves here to listen to the podcast.
Again, you didn't know that you were dealing with two people pleasers, but now you do, Nicholas, and maybe you will be on this stage, so who knows?
So I'm so glad that we, like, met in this moment. I'm Joe.
And I'm Andrew.
And this is...
Good Children!
Oh my god.
What's so sick is, like, I don't think we realized when we started this that, like, that would be our, like, signature, our intro.
It took a while to get our footing there. Yeah, for sure. There were some off harmonies. There were some good harmonies.
I don't know if we've ever gotten to a good harmony.
I don't think so either. My cousin Leanne would be like, you really need to... Yeah, you really need to figure that one out.
No, like, okay. I think we've leaned into it at this point. But if anyone is a vocal coach, like... Please
listen,
reach out.
Meet us backstage because we have another performance tonight.
We need all the help we can get.
It's a power ballad. So,
yes.
Buckle up.
Yeah, no, I do. I have to say, like, what we intro to pales in comparison to what we outro to. And I think that, like, I want everyone sobbing.
Yeah,
like,
no, we're taking you on a roller coaster of emotions. If you're laughing, you're ending
tears.
Sobbing, walking out. The next people coming in are gonna be like, what the fuck? Literally, do they scream at them? Like, probably. Oh my god.
Also, I just want to, like, address a controversy we had last week where I said some inflammatory things about the Eras tour, and
Joe was getting canceled.
It's literally fine. Like, I'm taking a lesson from Khloe Kardashian. I'm, like, getting thick skin. I'm, like, really moving through it. I do think that, like, maybe some people need to, like, learn what a joke is, but it's fine. Like, I did say it was the worst thing to ever happen to me.
And I don't think that we say that truly about everything.
Again, just now. But I feel like this is our own personal Eras tour moment. Like, this is a sold out room, and there are people who could not get here tonight, and those people, I think, would have paid $50,000 per ticket.
Yeah, I'm just gonna upcharge your ticket, you guys.
That might be next for us.
I know.
We're gonna get into scalping.
Yeah, no. Oh, yeah. Personally, we're gonna be scalping.
We're
the
gonna scalp
outside.
Our own tickets.
Yeah, we're gonna be like, hey guys, we got tickets. Come on in. Yeah, but you did, like, really well, Joe. Honestly, like, dealing with the hate comments.
Listen,
that you got.
No, we haven't posted TikTok since. I haven't opened the app again.
We honestly haven't. Joe, but the thing is with you, it's like every time we post a little video, if there's hate, you're like, Andrew, let me read you these comments about you. I'm like, what do you mean? He's like, yeah.
It
sounds like your voice has been put through a
hydraulic
press. I'm like, what?
That one was, like, rough.
That was rough. And it was over my Pastina video. I'm like, no. What was it?
It was actually, you weren't even really talking in it. No. But they were called, it was the...
Oh, no, it was the spaghetti squash.
Oh, it was spaghetti squash.
I said,
squash.
Fuck
you were
spaghetti
talking.
Squash. And
hydraulic
the world
press.
Shut down. Jeez.
I just can't deal with the comments, like, and I feel like I shouldn't have to bear the weight alone, like, you know what I mean?
I'm sitting in the other room, he's like, yeah, this person really fucking hates you. I'm like, okay, if we can just stop, because I'm not looking at them for that reason, but thank you.
But I'm forced to look at them, like, I have no choice, because I'm community manager.
Yeah,
you know?
Joe's my manager, Joe's my socials, Joe's my, I'm
it's
just
It's too
here.
Much even for me sometimes,
oh,
like, it's really intense.
Honestly, like, the yellow chair with your complexion right now is looking fantastic.
I can't believe you would say that.
Like, Jenny, we did buy a new chair because of Jenny. So.
Jenna Lee ruined my life. Jenna Lee is a listener who took it upon herself to set design our entire podcast and was like, your quote-unquote yellow skin with that yellow chair is disgusting. And... I mean, for a few reasons, that's horrid. That's a hard thing to say.
So you killed her with kindness. You were
I
like,
killed her with kindness by saying you're
you
right.
So much. I just ordered a new chair. I just ordered a new chair, Jenny, and it's blue. So
and then,
if you have anything to say, keep it to yourself.
But then she said, and those polka dot curtains behind you, when are those going to go? And I was like, you're pushing it now. Like, we were sweet, but, like, you can't get this deep with me now.
She's going to be our task.
Those
brother.
Are
she's
vintage IKEA.
That shit out. I mean... Come on.
No, Jenna Lee is, like, haunting my nightmares. Her and Billy Bob Joe right now. Like, I can't. I literally can't.
No, but Billy Bob Joe, he...
Is Billy Bob Joe in the room?
No.
Can you imagine?
I feel safe. I feel better.
The scariest moment of my life.
Oh, my God. I will say also, I'm seeing some people in the crowd, and your outfits are incredible. Some of our friends were texting us. They were like, they're in fur coats. I was like, yeah, they're coming to the gala, the Good Children Gala.
It is the Good Children Gala.
Little did you know. Oh, my God.
Speaking of outfits, I do want to just really quickly plug merch. Like, you know, like, we're doing housekeeping. Our friends Rachel and Alex are, like, honestly fighting for their lives behind that merch stand. Like, we informed them a couple hours ago that this would be happening for them. So, like, bear with them. They honestly, they came in uniform, which is really impressive.
They did.
But feel free to check out our merch. We have shirts, we have totes, and those will also be going online on Friday, for Black Friday.
I did create the website.
You coded.
I coded, you guys. That is.
You literally are a woman in STEM. I'm really proud of you.
I am a woman in STEM.
It's crazy.
It took about 5 weeks, but I, on Squarespace, which probably has the instructions on how to set up the website, but I did it, and it looks amazing. So goodchildrenpod.com if you want to check it out.
I was, like, checking in every couple of days.
You were like,
hey, like, where's the website?
I'm like, Joe, you need to give me a second. I'm stressed.
But I did really respect that you actually coded something. Like, your childhood, you would not believe that.
No.
Adult me can't believe it.
No, exactly.
Like, it really is impressive.
But
were
I was
checking
say,
your
like,
notes just now.
Which I was like,
I don't think we need to hide
legible?
It. What'd you say?
I said, are they legible?
Oh, you said gerbil. And I was like, we don't have the same notes.
Do you want to talk about gerbils? Like, I mean, like,
I never had a gerbil,
about...
but gerbils always kind of freaked me out. You know what I mean?
You had my hamster, though.
I had your hamster. I had my hamster. I had a few hamsters in my life.
Any animal that didn't work for me and my family, we were like, hey, Joe, can you honestly, like, I have this really cute hamster, Lilo. Like, if you want to take
her, Lilo.
She chewed through the metal cage. But, like, that's literally fine. Like, queen.
Lilo, like, I'm telling you, Lilo is still in the walls of my childhood home. Like, she's there somewhere. She's thriving. Like,
your cat gobbled
probably,
her
like,
up.
No. Like, she's built a colony. There's so many hamsters now. She's offspring.
She is offspring.
Yeah.
Oh. I love it.
That's my gerbil talk.
That's your gerbil talk.
Yeah.
I was going to bring up our on stage experience before.
Oh my God, that's a perfect segue.
Do you want to talk about... Honestly, this is a really big deal, Joe. Talk about
this your This is literally the first time in my entire life I'm on a stage. Like, this is insane to me. Like, it's... On the way here, we were also having that moment where we were like, is this crazy? Like, is what we're doing crazy? Like, we rehearsed a little... We went through the run-through one time, and then we were like, okay, let's take notes on what we said. And from there, we just showed up. And, like, the level of anxiety I had wasn't that high.
No, we did pop a little CBD gummy on the way.
A couple.
Because we were like, I was driving the car, and my anxiety was through the roof. And behind the stage, I will say, I am somebody who has testing anxiety, so before any test, I'm going to fail. I'm going to literally fail. And then I'm the person that gets the 100, and they're like, oh, my God, fuck that kid. Yeah, that literally was me. So
Andrew wanted to go onto the stage while you guys were in the audience and grab his notebook so he could start studying the notes that
we
had.
He was like, why the hell are you studying?
I was like, we're just talking. Like,
I'm like, you're honestly so right. But, yeah, once he said that, I perked up.
This fly is really obsessed with you.
The fly is obsessed with me. I'm like...
It's your sweet blood.
Oh, my God, it's refreshing. I'm obsessed.
You have stage experience, though.
Like, I mean, it's like minor stage experience, but like I definitely was in an a cappella group in college. Yes,
Chimes.
Oh my God, the Loyola Chimes. Yeah, we were barefoot. We were definitely barefoot on
stage.
And that was definitely a move on their part.
Can you explain that? Like, is there an explanation?
Do you want to explain it, TJ? Oh, okay.
Oh, my God. I thought it was like...
They just told me it was tradition, so I was like, oh, yeah. That's actually exactly why I don't have
shoes
on.
I thought you
were
trying to pick up the sound of the stomping, and I was like, you guys, we pushed it too far.
Yeah, no, it was bizarre. But yeah, I have 3 years. I guess that's 3 years of stage experience. But I do think that we also have about, 21 years of pretend stage experience.
Yeah. Nothing feels more natural to me than this moment. Yeah. Like, I'm like, yeah, right, this is where we were supposed to be at 11 years old with our flip video.
As I'm coming over and Joe's like, okay, today we're recording, so like, I have a plan and you just need to follow. And I'm like, yeah, I love direction. Let's do this. Let's go.
And then I would get so mad. Yeah. I'd be like, why don't you know exactly what we're doing right now?
Yeah, like the video that, like, the entrance video, it's like, what do we want to talk about?
And you're like, I just got here.
My dad just dropped me off. Like, what are you saying?
From like my 15 sports practices, like you had no time to prepare.
No, not
I was
at
like,
all.
I've been waiting all day for this. Get to work.
Yeah.
Yeah, perform.
But thank God, because now we have about, what, 200,000 pictures and videos archived?
Yeah, no, the archive is sick and it's deep and like sometimes it's haunting. But I think that like... I think that we want to like share more of it as we travel along this journey, but also like yeah, we're gonna share some more tonight.
Share a little bit more, and we're gonna go off stage for about 2 seconds, and then we're gonna come back and we're gonna talk about Thanksgiving.
Oh my God!
All right, we'll be right back.
All right, we had our kindergarten Thanksgiving. How do you know how to do these ballerina moves? Just comes naturally.
Because I needed this damn fan, because I don't know where we're in tuxedos. I'm going to pass out.
No, I'm like so glad we're all here to discuss the worst holiday of all time, which is Thanksgiving.
Yes!
Yeah. Clap if you hate Thanksgiving.
Yes.
Like, okay.
Nobody did. Like, we're literally like, okay, so we actually love Thanksgiving. If you guys like Thanksgiving,
clap if you love Thanksgiving.
Oh, Joe, we have to change our narrative. And
that's what
it quick.
I was saying. I was saying the same thing. I love Thanksgiving.
You love Thanksgiving. I will really say the thing about Thanksgiving, it's not even Thanksgiving. We'll get to the food because that's the best part. But Thanksgiving Eve, I do want to talk about Thanksgiving.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, but it's tomorrow, guys. So, like,
it's fully right now. Like, yeah, we are going to usher in Thanksgiving Eve together by the end of this night.
And you're here. But the thing about Thanksgiving Eve is, like, it's the flex of going back home and you're like, I'm going out to the bars tonight. I'm literally gonna do it. And like, you can't tell me I'm not.
And there's always like a 45 minute window of room where you're like, I'm not going.
I'm not going. Like, you're like, I feel
I'm
actually
staying in, like I'm not doing this.
I feel like tomorrow's Thanksgiving, like I can't be drunk.
Like,
I can't
am I going over tomorrow? TBD.
I'm going, I will be going.
If you go, I have to go.
You
can't go without me. I was sick last year. I'm like still upset about
it. Joe, I think that you're just like performatively saying you're sick because it's like last year, like I had to be thrown to the wolves. I was there. I was like, hey, you guys. They were like, what the hell are you doing here? I'm like, hey, it's me.
No, I always am a little bit ill on Thanksgiving, but that's because it's not a good holiday.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry. Like,
boo!
No.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah, anybody on the other side, I'm just going to take your side. I'm like, yes,
I just feel like, okay, but no, like, I want to circle back to Thanksgiving Eve before I, like, really shit-talk Thanksgiving. I do love Thanksgiving Eve because it is, like, the one night a year that you get to, like, be famous. Like, you walk into those bars, you're like, hey, you guys, I'm back. Like, I'm finally here. Like,
I haven't seen you in five years. I'm like,
it's tis the damn season. It's really like that moment.
It is tis the damn season.
It feels so good to have Swifties in the audience, like, obviously, but like, it's a relief.
It is.
Yeah, but you like walk into those bars. For me, nobody knows who I am. Not one person. Like, the only way someone will recognize me is if I'm with you, which is also like true of like walking down the street now.
Like, and this is Joe.
Yeah.
Although like you've been spotted recently without me and been.
Wait, when?
With Ross.
Oh yes, yeah. I was spotted and Andrew was recognized with me, but it was not Andrew.
It was not. Love your podcast.
No, but I feel like, again, back to Thanksgiving Eve, like the entire feeling of yeah, like, I'm walking into those bars, I'm like, wow, you guys, like, it's like little old me, like, back in town, like, I'm here, I'm gonna get a beer at the bar and like wear Carhartt and like look solemn. And then and literally then one to one and a half people recognize who I am. Yeah. And then like, I just am like, I need to go home right now. Or I really start drinking.
You start drinking. Okay, I need to tell the story because it's like,
that was fucked up.
Everybody
that was a
here
horrible
needs
night.
To know the Babylon story. And like, I will say you were battling for your life, Babylon, the, for
yeah.
sure.
But people, I was not the first to go that night. We started at Caroline's Stewart pregame. She did not make it off her dining room table. Yeah. We barely made it out with the group for the
actual
event. It's
because this is the
event.
Problem. This was the problem.
You. It's and you. You're the problem.
I'm the problem. It's me. It's like, why
you came
like
with a water bottle full of vodka.
24 years old showing up with a water bottle of vodka. Like, if it's
like,
16
who's like,
years old.
Like, did you graduate college?
She's like, okay, I got White Claws. I'm like, no, I have the water bottle. So this is what we're... This is what we're gonna do.
Yeah, so obviously I'm gonna match your energy. Yeah, I don't have the stamina you have.
No, I'm
lo and behold, I'm being tank. Kicked out of a bar in Babylon. And I'm immediately
did you, like,
claiming
knock down?
Yeah, it was valid. I did knock over an entire wall of bottles that then shattered. Oh my god, your shirt. I'm so sorry. That just stopped me dead in my tracks.
No, but I'm a shaking.
What's your name?
What's your name?
Eve. Oh my god, hello. Stop.
This is really
it's Eve.
She's wearing an I'm Mom's Favorite shirt.
Oh my god.
And I wore an I'm Mom's Favorite shirt
Wait,
when I was 4 years
that's
old.
That's actually so good. That's incredible.
Oh my god, that's
that actually made me I just left this room.
Yeah, no. We ascended.
That's incredible.
Oh my gosh. But yeah, like no, back I'm, to the Babylon story.
Yeah,
like,
sorry.
The thing is about us too, we get sidetracked really quick. It's like a fucking dog. So I will say, we left the club after Joey got kicked out.
I was like, the bouncers were homophobic, you guys. Like, not a surprise. Like, this is what we get for going out. Like, I'm being a victim of homophobia because I spilled 85 beer bottles on the floor in this tiny ass bar.
Of Long Island, like, yeah. So I order the Uber, and Joe gets in the Uber. He's like this.
I feel like you're making that up.
I'm like, Joe, we gotta figure it out. We get all the way back to my house. You're still in the Uber.
Yeah.
It wasn't looking good.
No.
So I'm like, if you get me a 3-star rating, I'm gonna literally fucking scream. So you better perk up.
It was the scariest Andrew has ever been in his entire life. Like, the look of doom in his eyes as he said that to me, like, rattled me completely to my core and, like, woke me right up. And, like, it is, to me, like, one of the most traumatizing things to ever happen to me.
Yeah.
As he, like, slammed the door shut and then sashayed to his house, I was like, I'm actually a horrible person.
I was like, he got the message, okay? So next
year, I did
get
the message.
And next year, you were conveniently really sick.
Was that?
You were ill, so I don't know.
Yeah, no, I think I've learned my limits.
You have learned your limits.
And it's just like, don't trust you. And that's amazing.
Oh my god, no. Oh my god, speaking of limits, I do want to talk a little bit about, we're going to get into the food because, don't worry, I did prepare a Thanksgiving meal behind the stage that we will eventually bring out onto
the
stage.
It was fully 7:32 and Andrew was shoveling mashed potatoes onto a plate backstage.
Yeah.
Like,
I was like, we have another show after this, what the hell am I going to eat? I was like, we're going to have a Thanksgiving meal on stage, but talking about limits, I do want to talk about the Mr. Hoffman story. I want to talk about middle
school for
a second. Oh, my
God. Yes.
Yeah. So do you want to explain who Mr. Hoffman is and, like, maybe explain him?
Mr. Hoffman, one of the many loves of my life,
yeah.
was my 7th grade science teacher.
Yeah.
He was just, to me, like, actually, I think, influenced my entire personality. Like, he does not know this. Like, this is, like, this is a secret that I'm revealing in this moment.
Seth, are you here? No. Never mind.
I would actually freak out.
Yeah.
No, I'd have to leave. But for Thanksgiving one year, he was like, your assignment is to, like, and this is why I loved him. My science assignment was to fill up my Thanksgiving plate with as much food as possible.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, easy, I'm getting 100. Like, this is it. Like, it's finally happening.
Anyway.
But it was also, like, to bring it down, like, sadly, the only excuse I had to, like, fill a plate. Because you know me, I was like, I'm not hungry. Like, I'm going to have one piece of turkey.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I always have had plate anxiety. Blue is right.
No, now we fill the fucking plate, and it's heaping and seeping through that fucking plate.
Yeah.
It's like, no, I want the...
I'm on that side now as an adult.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
But as a child, I was, like, literally portion controlling it. It was so sick. But not for Seth, not for Mr. Hoffman.
Seth said, fuck Weight Watchers, yeah.
He really changed it for me. But you're like a full, you're obviously a plate filler, right?
Oh, I'm a plate filler to my core, absolutely. Why do I care if anyone's looking at my plate?
You've always inspired me in that sense.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm going to go up for seconds, and I'm going to go up for thirds. And if you're judging me, that's literally on you.
You're like the the queen.
I don't need to do any work. You need to do some work.
Always first in line at the buffet. Always. No fear of judgment.
No, I'm throwing elbow. Like, listen, like, I get it. Like, it's like, oh, let your grandparents let everybody go first.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, I'm going to throw freaking elbows, and I'm getting the penne alla vodka, and like, don't even worry about it. Right?
Yeah.
Yes! Yes! Here's the throwing elbows for the food at the buffet. I love this. I feel good.
Is your Thanksgiving like buffet style?
There's definitely a spread.
Right, but like on the table spread?
No, it's more of like on an island spread. So yeah, you are going up and you're definitely filling the plate.
But I'm like trashing it up by calling it buffet style.
Yeah, I'm like, yeah. It's not a buffet, it's a spread. It's a spread. But it's definitely a beautiful spread. what about your Thanksgiving? Is it on the table?
I feel like it was on the table always. I feel like all the food was... This year's Thanksgiving?
Oh, geez.
No, there's a lot of drama in my family for Thanksgiving this year. No, it's I'm not serious. I'm kidding.
No, we do live for some Thanksgiving.
No, there is a little bit. So my sister is hosting Thanksgiving this year, and she was like, I have a brilliant idea. Like, we're going to still have turkey, but we're also going to have corned beef.
Yeah. Yes.
And... needless to say, like, my mother, upon hearing this information, burst into tears, sobbing hysterically about how her childhood has been ruined. She was like, there goes, like, every last thing about my childhood. Like, you ruined no more gingerbread houses, no more pumpkins, now corned beef on Thanksgiving. Sobbing.
A Thanksgiving sin.
But there has been, like, they've reached an agreement where the corned beef will not leave the kitchen, so my mom doesn't have to see it, but it's still gonna be served.
Listen, and, like, I do like corned beef, there's just a time and place.
There's a time and a place, and it's not Thanksgiving.
Absolutely not.
And my sister is fully in the audience hearing the story.
Sorry, like, sorry, Amanda. That's a really
it's just the
one.
Truth. We have to
but I will say, like, at least, like, growing up, I don't know... clap if you're Italian.
Yes.
Oh my God.
Yes.
Yeah.
Feels good.
Yeah, it feels really good, you guys. All right. Our listeners are 95% women and Italian. That's great. That's good to hear. But I will say that as of late, we have kicked those traditions to the curb.
The Italian traditions?
Only because it was like growing up. Why was I starting the Thanksgiving meal with pasta?
With a lasagna on occasion.
With a lasagna. Why were there meatballs? I'm like, there are meatballs on the table. I'm going to have them over the turkey.
As a literal appetizer.
Yeah.
Like, that was the first thing on the plate.
Yeah.
After, like, an antipasto. And then, suddenly you're having literally, like, a baked pasta.
Yeah.
And then it's, like, time for Thanksgiving dinner.
I'm ready for stuffing. I'm really ready. I'm happy I wore this quarter zip because it's fucking really good.
You love a quarter zip.
I'm obsessed with the quarter zip still to this day.
Still to this day, but since you're from a child into your finger. Yes. Quarter zip.
My quarter zip.
Let's hear it for quarter zip.
This is great.
Thanksgiving fashion is very much a moment.
Yeah.
No, would you say quarter zips is your moment for Thanksgiving?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, like, obviously, like, you can wear the flannels, but the quarter zips is just spicing it up in the way that it needs to be spiced up.
I'm, like, team flannel the whole time, but that's my conservative cosplay. Like, that's my moment.
Yeah, it's like, it is. You are a cosplayer.
I'm like, I just got off the truck. Like, I'm here, you guys. Like,
yeah, I got my boots on.
Yeah, like, hopefully.
Yeah, what's up, bro?
Like, why do I literally own Timberlands?
I honestly don't know.
I have not done a day of manual labor in my entire life. And I only am dressing at this point like I work on a dairy farm.
Yes.
Like, that is my objective.
Yep.
Clap for dairy farms. Yes! Yes. Yes. Oh my god, like big oat milk is dead tonight, you guys. We got her. We
oat
finally
milk
got her.
Is dead. No, I like oat milk. I did also post, we did post about, I said,
you said
oat
fuck
milk.
Oat milk.
Yeah, no, I did.
Now you like it?
Listen,
this is
like,
the problem
do you guys
with
like
us.
Oat milk? Yeah, it is the problem. I did
we
say,
never
oat milk
know.
Is out. Listen, the thing is sometimes about oat milk, I do have, I'm lactose intolerant and I have crippling IBS. Oh, yes! Yes, I have crippling IBS and that's totally fine. That's on me. But I will say about oat milk is like, sometimes, you guys, I just get a latte with oat milk and it fully tastes like
oats.
I'm drinking oatmeal.
Yeah.
And like, totally fine. Like, I know the consequences that I'm gonna have to face if I'm getting the whole milk, like, whatever. But like, if you're gonna get a latte, like, I'm gonna get it with the whole milk.
Are you though?
That's what I'm saying. No, I will say that I probably would get whole milk maybe once a month to treat my.
Yeah,
it's a treat.
I feel like that's correct.
It's a treat. I switch between
to
almond
reset
and oat.
The system.
Okay,
it's like a colonic. Like you just get it once a month.
Yeah, I get it. Yeah, I'm like, yeah, I get it once a month, you guys. That's my problem.
I mean, but you've had ever. I mean, like not to bring up your stomach illnesses, but like,
no,
I feel like. No, like we plan to talk about it.
We did plan to talk about this, and this is becoming my Barbara Walters
moment. This is fully, yeah. I feel like it's time you really like speak your truth and tell your story like live in front of an audience.
Okay, well, you want to hear about my digestive tract? Okay, it's Thanksgiving, so I guess it's like it's important. I will say, just growing up, you know what
the,
I mean.
Like, the pineapple pizza.
Yeah, I want to talk about Hawaiian Pizzagate. Because Hawaiian Pizzagate, like, Joe, do you want to explain the story?
It was a night like any other night for us. We probably were in fourth grade. We were getting multiple Domino's pies for the two of us. And one of those pies was simply a Hawaiian pizza, which I don't really care what you're going to say. Like, sometimes pineapple does belong on pizza, especially when it's Domino's. Do you know what I mean? Like, we're not putting it on, like, a real New York slice. It's Domino's pizza, some ham, some pineapple. Andrew, I took it too far for you.
You took it way too far. And the thing is, Joe, like, if you're going to do something, like, especially when we were little, like, I'm going to just follow it.
Right.
Like, I was like, okay, Joe's putting the garlic sauce on this Hawaiian pizza. I'm going to put the garlic sauce on this Hawaiian pizza. So I'm sopping this pizza slice with garlic sauce. I'm like, this is my call. This is it. I'm eating that slice, I would say within 10 minutes. Within
I think
minutes,
it was instantaneous.
Yes. Yeah. My face immediately
I saw
turned.
Your face and I knew something went wrong really quickly.
Yeah, because like, why the hell were you putting garlic sauce on your pineapple?
Listen, like, I have a developed palate.
You,
like, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, I'm
you have
really
a steel stomach and like some of us
yeah,
just don't
that's
have
actually
that talent.
What it is. But you, I feel like I've only ever seen you eating something about to throw up. You know what I mean? Like, in a
right.
in a loving, like in a loving way, like that is your like your
yeah.
osmosis.
And listen, if you have a throw up trigger, like this is not the show for you. But I will
I'm so
say,
sorry,
like,
Alex.
Like I'm literally so sorry, Alex. But it's just like growing up, like it was something that everybody in my family they were like, okay, like Andrew's gonna have a slice of pizza, and like it's not gonna be good. Like we know it's just like it's gonna be instantaneous. So like get the plates ready like immediately. Like. It's not good, and that it just, it's been on people, in cars, post IHOP, post Thanksgiving. I know is right.
Post IHOP? Was it in IHOP?
Post IHOP. And okay. I'm like, listen, if you want me to do it in IHOP, like it was happening there too.
Who
so, like,
want you to?
Oh, no, like you don't want me to do that. But I will say, it's been a tough journey to get to this point, but like my stomach has really made a full recovery, and that's on oat milk.
I'm so proud of you.
So thank you. But yeah, Thanksgiving is, I mean, it's a doozy.
It is a doozy. It also is like now it's become this time of year where people are like, let's work out. Like, what's going on?
Listen.
Why are we trotting? What's a turkey
Why
trot?
Why are you trotting for your turkey?
What the fuck is a turkey trot? Like, how did we get to this point culturally?
Listen. Like, I get it. Like, we definitely want to trot, I guess.
I'm
but, like,
so happy for the trotters
like, you
out
guys,
there. But
today's Thanksgiving, so we have a 90-minute soul cycle ride, and we're going to burn it
we
out.
We did it, and we did that.
We did, and it was, Joe, how would you say you felt?
I mean, I probably felt really good.
I know,
but being honest.
Like,
but in retrospect, I was like, what compelled me to sign up for not one, but two Soul Cycle classes and, like, make it the morning of Thanksgiving?
It's not two for the price of one.
No, it's not. It's almost like two for the price of three.
Yeah, they're like, it's going to be $120 and you're going to cycle for 90 minutes. And I'm like, how do these people move their legs that fast?
No.
I'm like, how are they tapping it back that quick? I'm I get it.
I just don't get how we have, like, that's become the thing.
It has definitely become the thing. I will say, like, it's almost, listen, there's almost a threat around Thanksgiving.
I'm feeling threatened.
I'm like, Thanksgiving's coming up. You better fucking work.
Work out. It's like the new summer body is Thanksgiving. Yeah. It's like literally, like, we have to take this one down next. Like, it's also, oh no, I might have lost my thought. You guys, hurry up.
Oh my God. Oh, you still want to talk about the skit? Skip. I do want to talk about the queer experience when it comes to Thanksgiving, and that is the dog show.
The Westminster Dog Show.
The Dog Show! Yes! I'm like, you're watching football? Let me see those dogs.
It is really. The Westminster Dog Show is for the girls and the gays. Like,
the girls,
it's really, like, it is the one time of that day where I know full peace. And I'm like, I'm watching a Bichon Frise do 85 laps in a tunnel around an arena, and people are clapping for it. Yeah. Like, that's my dream job. I want to be that Bichon Frise.
This is kind of a dog show.
In a way that I think this is fully just dogs.
Yeah.
Like, if you replace us with, for you, I would say, you really give me French Bulldog. Like,
I mean, like, I don't know if that's good, because it's like, don't they, like, walk a little bit and then they're like, I'm like, I do love
they
a French
They have breathing issues, they but, do, like, that's no
I mean,
need
I
to
guess be. Same, you're right. That's, I guess that's kind of, I would say, like, for you, like, I don't know, Joe, like, maybe, like, a greyhound, and the only
oh
reason,
my God.
And it's not because you're a racer, it's literally because, like,
my anxiety.
One, your anxiety. Two, you would absolutely be seen spotted around Brooklyn wearing little booties and, like,
oh my God,
and, like, a little jacket to go with
it.
No,
like, they put the greyhounds in those chunky turtlenecks. Like, that is my dream.
That literally is
That's, like, who
so
I want to become. Yeah.
That makes so much sense.
It does make a lot of sense.
I'm
going to
be thinking
you.
About the French Bulldog for the rest of the
It just makes sense.
It does make sense. No, right? Like, what would you say?
What do you think? You say?
What do you think? A poodle?
Oh, a poodle makes a lot of sense.
They're smart as hell, Joe. Yep. And they're sweet. Labradoodle. Okay. I can
We're pushing it with the doodles
I'm
now.
Like, guys, like, Joe, no. Get off stage. What else? No. But Labradoodle for sure. I'll go with Labradoodle.
Yeah, no, I do. I guess I could see a poodle for you.
Okay.
I'm hearing more poodles.
Poodle.
Poodle. Okay, fine. I'm willing to accept when I'm wrong.
Okay, Joe, like, what about Joe? If it's not a greyhound...
I'm afraid of what the answer's going to
be. Yeah, me too, but let's hear it. Pomeranian. Yes.
That's kind of cute.
I love a Pomeranian.
I love being a Pomeranian, actually. I'm taking it, and I'm running with it.
Okay, Pomeranian and Labradoodle, I feel much better.
Boo the Pomeranian.
What'd you
remember
say?
Boo?
Boo.
You remember Boo? You
okay,
guys.
Now we're guys. This is the dog
this is the
show.
Dog show.
I'm like, I don't know what's happening. I'm like, you're just screaming dogs at us. Stop. This is like,
overwhelmed.
Is this my nightmare? Is this real? Oh my God. Oh my God. I mean, like, I will say before I bring out the Thanksgiving plate, I don't know how we're gonna eat it, but we're all in it together. I do want to transition to just like Thanksgiving songs. Are there Thanksgiving songs that I'm missing?
Is anyone here familiar with Nicole Westbrook?
Yes, let's hear it for our girl Nicole.
Imagines, not one person. You guys know the song. It was like viral on Tumblr in like 2013. It was like, it's Thanksgiving. We're gonna have a good time.
Yes.
Okay, so for the six people who know that song, that's the best Thanksgiving song.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
And it's good.
I think that was peak Thanksgiving.
Apparently it wasn't. I let everyone... That's something that really surprises me is, like, not everyone has the same cultural references as me. And, like, sometimes I do cut too deep.
Yeah.
And maybe Nicole Westbrook was a bridge too far.
Yeah. You said Nicole Westbrook. I fully know that song. But I'm like, who the hell is Nicole Westbrook? No, the thing is about you is like you just have an insane memory about the littlest things. So it's just like that's when you pull out Nicole Westbrook. It kind of is a flex. Like I gotta be like, whoa.
Give me like any single guest actor on any single Disney Channel original series, like from 2006 to 2014, and I can tell you like if they have a kid right now. You know, like that's like where my values are at. Like I'm keeping tabs on those people. Has a child, and Maria, we actually were on her Instagram earlier this week, literally.
We were like, what is she up to? Is she still doing it?
Ana Maria Perez de Tagle of Camp Rock, of Hannah Montana. She was also in something else.
Was she in Sweet? No, she wasn't in
Sweet. I don't believe so.
Camp Rock.
Yeah, Camp Rock.
Camp Rock.
That's chill. Yeah, no, she has a child. She's like an Instagram blog. Like, she's like an Insta. What are those called? Influencer. Oh my god. Like, I'm so out of touch with the internet. I really don't use it.
He doesn't know.
No, but she's someone who I hold dear in my heart. Like, I need a star vehicle return for Ana Maria PDT.
Yeah.
Like, she was the highlight of Camp Rock. I'm sorry. I'm sorry to Allison Stoner, but...
And Peggy.
Peggy.
So I've said this, like, I do think that... And I don't want you to take this the wrong way. Like, you are so Peggy, because it's just like, you would show up to the festival.
Final jam.
The final jam, and pull out a guitar, sing your little song, and win.
And
I'm like, it's literally like Peggy was Taylor Swift in that moment.
And you are Megan Jett Martin.
I'm too cool for you.
You're Tess. Yeah.
Even though
like we both firmly believe we're Mitchie Torres. Like that's
I know, we like both don't want to admit it, but I'm like, yeah, this is me like really makes sense for me.
No. Are there any other Thanksgiving songs?
I think there was like an Adam Sandler song that floated around for a second. That's like the only one I remember. But I do think that like it's maybe like our next move.
I was gonna say it should be like Sabrina Carpenter's.
You're right.
If you wanna take it from her, like that's fine.
Yeah, you're right. Or her, like again, it's Sabrina Carpenter, it's Meghan Trainor could do a song that would hit Target like it's never hit anything before. Target would eat that shit up. They were like, it's Thanksgiving. Meghan Trainor hit it.
Meghan Trainor should capitalize on that market.
She absolutely should.
She could literally annihilate the other girls.
She would.
Like, Christmas is not going to be for her. We have Mariah and Ariana every year is scraping away
and
at
that. And we have Ashley Tisdale.
Yes. Yeah, Ashley Tisdale's last Christmas cover.
Yeah.
I remember hearing that in my mom's car for the first time in like 2007 and like looking out the window and being like, I finally know what heartbreak is. Like, I was like, wow, like, I'm never gonna love again because last Christmas I gave you my heart. Like, she spoke, God spoke through Ashley Tisdale.
Yes.
For that cover.
Often, yeah, for sure.
Everything she's
every
ever
single,
done.
Every single word out of that woman's mouth.
She's
like,
a true artist.
Yeah, she is.
It's biblical. Fully.
Oh my God, yeah. But I think it's our next step. Like, we will definitely
Thanksgiving music.
We did want to record a Christmas album, but I think that's not gonna happen.
The thing is, like, we've been recording Christmas albums since we were like literally children. Like every year. I recently found I was gonna play it tonight, but honestly, I fell ill. But we were my Christmas of a lifetime.
Yeah, Joe,
never
really
forget.
Good.
Andrew opens it with an intro at the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade, where I'm on the Give a Gift Foundation float, and which I don't believe is a real foundation, but we made it up in that moment.
Sue.
But it was like, I feel like we were in my playroom on GarageBand, putting in the hours year after year for
like
a Christmas
anyone
album.
Was, like, you weren't even going to release it.
No, it was
just
for us.
It was just for us. That was
But that was all of this also.
Yeah.
It was just for us.
And now it's for you.
Now it's for you guys.
So it's like the videos that were like, oh, we're not gonna put that out there because I think that people are gonna be like, ooh.
What, Christmas of a Lifetime?
Yeah. We're like, oh, they're a little weird.
They crossed the line.
What?
No, I was saying we crossed the line.
Oh, absolutely.
But Christmas of a Lifetime slaps. I'm just going to say it. You guys are obviously going to hear it within the next, like, 2 days.
Yeah.
Like, it's on my old-ass laptop that was my sister's that had all of her Good Children archive was on it, and I wiped it clean. I wiped the entire laptop clean in, like, middle school, and I was like, this is mine now. And she was like, where are my 10,000 pictures? And I was like, you have Facebook. Like, they're on Facebook. Like, don't worry about it. But that's the most haunting laptop. You were just looking at it earlier today. It is like bangers tour, bangers tour, bangers tour, bangers tour.
Twerk, twerk, twerk. Bangers. I'm like,
it has, I suspect the Nurgles are behind it, which is like a deep cut Harry Potter reference. Yeah, thank you. Hugs, not Uggs. That was an Ezra Koenig tweet. Ezra Koenig changed my entire life. Vampire Weekend was the most important thing to me at that time. Oh, of course. The Hunger Games? There was no Hunger Games sticker on my laptop.
No.
I was like wearing the merch.
Literally. Or if you're standing, I would leave. If I heard that.
No, this is my next cancellation. No, I was like wearing Hunger Games merch wherever I went. Like, I feel like I had temporary tattoos on at that point. Earlier today, I actually did softly weep to a fan edit of Katniss and Peeta set to set to The Great War by Taylor Swift. Yeah. I don't know. Like, I forgot my emotions for that franchise until I watched that. And I was like, I can't even believe what I'm watching right now. Like, I also am like, oh, Taylor Swift is a Hunger Games stan. Like, there's no other explanation. Yes. Oh, my God. Yes.
Save the Sound.
Right.
Oh, my God.
And Eyes Open. She did two songs in that soundtrack. Can you imagine?
No.
Safe and Sound also ruined my life.
Yeah.
I was like, I live in District 12. And it's not looking good.
Oh, my God. No, Joe, I think I'm like, honestly, like...
Are you hungies?
Yeah, I'm starving.
It's like, I was just like thinking about it.
I got Joe, like, I literally was like, I was running, again, as I was running around Williamsburg today, being like, Joe needs to eat. So I'm like, we need to get some food. I got the sushi. Joe had one piece of the sushi. And I'm like, Joe, you're actually going to pass.
It was Whole Foods sushi. It was Whole Foods sushi.
I mean, like,
listen, sometimes it's amazing.
You like Whole Foods sushi?
I don't know if Andrew looked at the expiration date on the sushi. I don't think it was made today.
Listen, if the Whole Foods,
nor
if the
yes.
That's what I'm saying, because if the sushi is out, I'm just going to trust that it's literally fine.
It was like rock hard and wet.
I mean, it was rock hard and wet, so what?
I just like couldn't stomach it. I couldn't stomach it, you know. It was a rough couple of days. All I've been thinking about for the past 5 minutes is like, we have no like intermission clip to play.
Oh yeah.
So like we're just gonna have to go get the plates and come back and out while you guys sit here in silence.
You want me to fully come out?
Oh, I mean, we could both do it.
Okay, let's do it.
I don't want to be alone.
We're gonna be back in like literally 2 seconds because I played it myself.
We could like talk while
we're
here.
All right, guys. Yes, slay, slay. Oh my God, I think they're having fun.
Oh my God. Are we still on?
I think it's still on, and they're having fun. So this is all that matters.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
No, like,
okay. Guys.
First of all, I just want to check in on Nicholas.
It is a Dixie plate, fully.
Nicholas, how's it going?
Are you
Oh my God. That means a lot. Thank you.
Nicholas,
do you want like
fun?
A heap of ice cold mashed potatoes?
Yeah, like this is going to be really cold. And I will say, like, it is like an ice cream. I saw it and I was like, I kind of love that. Exactly. Like, this is all, this is not sponsored by Whole Foods, literally by any means, but this is all sponsored by Whole Foods.
This is an absurd plate.
So I do want to talk about what's on the plate because that's going to be our conversation topic about going into the food for Thanksgiving. So first is turkey. Joe, how do you feel about turkey?
Napkins. Turkey is napkins. I'm so sorry. Like,
that's what I'm saying.
The thing is, like I've had turkey prepared by so many people, by so many brilliant chefs.
You're having the wrong turkey.
Every single time I've had turkey by a million different from different kitchens, it's always been napkins.
Absolutely not.
And specifically, the Taco Bell compostable brown napkins.
I don't
give the exact same like aura as a slice of turkey.
I don't believe it because if it's a thick slab of turkey, first of all, my turkey's not. If the turkey is dry, I feel like that is the stressor.
Every time I've ever had turkey, it's dry.
Is the turkey gonna be dry this year? And you're like, don't even worry about it. Like it's gonna be totally fine. But like, I'm not having dry turkey. I love carved turkey, Joe.
I like really respect that. I enjoy it in certain instances.
I guess. Okay.
I enjoy it like in a wrap, in a sandwich.
The leftover Thanksgiving sandwiches.
Yes.
That's what makes it worth
That's
it.
The only way I'll enjoy turkey.
Okay, but like, are you a gravy head or are you a cranberry saucer?
I'm both. I'm literally, why not both? Okay. I love gravy. I feel like gravy is the main point of the meal. Like, okay. I would like to smother. Cranberry sauce. I'm looking at the sauce in front of us, and I'm not pleased.
Okay, I'll tell you why I'm not pleased about this cranberry sauce, you guys.
It's too
couldn't
fancy.
Find the one in the can. And I'm telling you, the cranberry sauce in the can, when you're opening it up and it's jiggling out, like, it's
that's
honestly
how it's
really
to be.
Good. That's
it's literally
nostalgia.
How it's supposed to be.
The homemade cranberry sauce sometimes is where you lose me.
It's an abomination.
Because it's like, you're getting the, it's a lot of work. You're getting the cranberries. You're getting the sugar. You're making a syrup. I'm like, just get the can. Just get the can. Just it's get, honestly, I'm not going to have work. Any contentions with the can. We know what it tastes like. And your cranberry sauce might be a little bit too bitter.
And it almost always is. And I feel like there's something comforting about the ridges on the can.
Yes.
Like, I'm like, that's home, that's family, that's Olive Garden.
Yeah, yeah, it's like, literally Olive Garden.
Like, it really
when
makes
you're here,
me
your
feel
family,
safe.
It's DiGiorno.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not delivery, it's canned.
It's canned
cranberry sauce.
So, like, honestly, like, my task for everybody in the audience is, like, if you're, like, for your Thanksgiving, just come with a can of cranberry sauce, because everyone's going to thank
done.
You for it. And just be like, the good children told us to bring the can of cranberry sauce. Next is stuffing, Joe.
Stuffing, of course. I have nothing bad to say about a stuffing, obviously. How could you possibly? You have a complaint?
No, I have nothing to say about it. No, I do have a few things
you're
to
done.
Say. I'm like, yeah, I'm done.
I'm out.
I'm done. Like, see you later. No, I do love a stuffing. I do love a stuffing. And like, I like a sausage stuffing. That's just me. Right?
Oh, yeah.
And the thing is about turkey. I hate to bring it back to turkey because I don't know how you're going to react. But I will say, like, when it comes to turkey, like, if the turkey is stuffed with stuffing. I mean, come on, you guys. That's the best thing I've ever had.
But I'd be more excited about the stuffing in that than the turkey.
Yeah, you're like scooping it.
Right. Like, which is a little bit disgusting.
No, I mean, like, I don't want to think about it too much. Kind of like
my
the French bulldog. I don't want to think about it.
No, but like, that makes me think about when I was a vegetarian, my tofurkey era. That was like.
No, we're not going to come on stage. Don't worry. We're not going to come on stage and shade any vegetarians in the audience.
No.
But I will say. Tofurkey.
Listen, I would prefer tofurkey over regular turkey at this point. Yeah,
it's
better.
It's good. Our girls in the front.
The thing about
tofurkey.
Like being a vegetarian, like I was a vegetarian for 6 years, like it's all about lying to yourself. And like that's how you get through it. You're like, this Impossible Burger tastes just like the real thing, if not better. Yeah. And like the
like,
more you say it, the more you repeat those mantras, like the more it comes true. You're like, no, like the fake chicken nuggets are exactly like the regular ones.
And again, your tofurkey.
I know
exactly
they are.
Like it.
They are. But I, as someone who converted back, I was like, these are not the same.
No.
Thing.
Again, the first time I saw tofurkey at a Thanksgiving dinner.
Was it Leanne's?
Leanne. Again, I am bringing up Leanne nonstop, but I will say she had a tofurkey. She was sitting right next to me. I'm like,
Trader Joe's tofurkey is the best one.
Okay. Okay. Let's hear it for Trader
let's
Joe's.
Let's hear it for
tofurkey.
Trader Joe's. I love
all
Trader
right.
Joe's.
No, but no. I will say, like, I maybe I'll have to run to Trader Joe's and try the tofurkey this year, but I'm not really sure. It's like, but yeah, I will say the last thing on our plate is mashed potatoes.
I wanted to see something. I wanted to just see something.
What is your name? Danny. You love mashed potatoes?
I love them.
Oh. Let's clap if you
does
like mashed potatoes.
Does this seem appealing to anyone in this moment? Like, why is it a snowball? Like, actually.
I'm, like, gonna use
so
the couch as a napkin.
Oh, I mean.
Guys, I will, honestly, we didn't bring up the couch story because, again, it's, like, a little bit disgusting. But, like, I use the couch in our apartment.
I think everyone knows.
Yeah, I know. You see it. You see it, right? Because I'm, like. No.
Yeah, no. We couldn't bring the actual couch because the FDA wouldn't regulate it.
They would say. Like,
we couldn't bring it into open spaces.
Like, please, we can't have people near within 10 feet, literally, of that couch. But
are we going to get into it?
I think that we're just going to, like,
this
try
feels
it.
Like Fear Factor. Like,
because it's like, how do you
it's
eat
so
and
cold.
How do you...
How
and
are you
guys,
doing
we're literally, if we could have provided a full Thanksgiving meal for each one of you in this room, like,
wait,
we genuinely would.
Do we?
Oh, yeah. So okay. As we're eating, like...
We have a little... We do have a little meal for a few lucky audience members.
Are you? Yeah. The gasps? Keep gasping because I think that this one's crazy. So
I'm actually taking my phone out.
Our friends at
one, two,
oh my God.
Three.
Panera! Listen, the Panera girls.
Yes, you guys. Panera bread.
Yes.
Okay, this is the craziest thing we've ever done. Look under your seats.
Look under your seats.
On the underneath of your seat, there might be a piece of paper taped to the bottom of your seat. Yes.
And you get a gift card. 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 You got Danny. I knew you were gonna get a gift card.
Gift cards all around,
guys. So there are 29 little pieces of paper around here. That's 29 gift cards
to Panera.
Panera for you to enjoy.
Yes, love wins.
Love does win for Thanksgiving.
Love is love is love.
All right. So all you need to do. I will say our friends at Panera, they definitely heard us talk about them.
Yeah, thank you so much to Panera Bread. I mean, for not only this, but what they have given us through our lives.
And the allies that have come with it.
A haven, a safe space.
The fanfic girls that also went to Panera. We love you all.
You guys, the instructions are on those, but send us a picture of it over email, and you will get your gift card sent to you.
Yeah, your web email, whatever.
Yes.
Web email?
Your what?
Your e-gift card. You know what I meant.
Yes. Oh my God, I can't believe we did that. I wish we did it as we were eating. It's all downhill from here, you guys.
It really is all downhill from here.
Unless you're staying for the second show, in which we're giving away 14 unique prizes.
14
including
good for
this chair.
Nothing. Yeah. Someone's leaving the Bell House with this chair, and it's not us.
And we don't care if you throw it on the curb. It just needs to leave. It just needs to get out of here. We have a new chair. But if you want the chair, stay for that second show.
I did hear someone say Tony's. I did say, Tony's chocolonely.
Yes.
Because Tony's chocolonely is some of the best chocolate I've ever had.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you, if you see it, for those that know, you know. If you don't know, it's probably the thickest chocolate you'll see in that store.
Absolutely.
Beautiful wrapping. Beautiful. It's going to be a pretty penny.
It's Willy Wonka. It's very Wonka.
It's very Wonka. But definitely get your Tony's Chocolonely.
Tony is our generation's Willy Wonka. I do believe
Tony is
my dream is to go to Tony's Chocolate Factory. You know what I mean? And drown in his chocolate river.
I agree.
Are you kidding?
You're kidding me.
The gasps. Everyone gasped.
Everyone's like,
they're building a Tony's Chocolate Factory?
Shut up. Oh my God.
Oh my God,
Joe.
Oh my God.
You used to work
there? First of all, thank you for being here tonight. I didn't know we were in the presence of royalty.
Yeah, actually.
That's insane to me.
Joe, we're going to Amsterdam.
We're going to Amsterdam and we're riding the Chocolonely coaster.
Yeah.
That's insane.
And you're all coming with us.
Yes.
Oh my God.
Look under your seats. Just kidding.
One lucky listener is going to be coming to Amsterdam with us. I will say, are you going to actually eat this plate of food?
I feel like we made a huge mistake in actually getting the food.
I agree.
Try it. I'm afraid to get it on my rented shirt.
I don't know if I'm going to try the mashed potatoes anymore. But
after you picked
I did
up
try
your...
the turkey, and the turkey was great. She was really saucing it up, though, in the Whole Foods. And I was hold the sauce, because I'm going to put the cranberry sauce on it myself. But it's honestly pretty good. It's really moist.
It's napkins. I'm so sorry. It's like a struggle to swallow. Do you know what I mean?
No. It's never
happened to you.
Struggle. Whoops. I will say. Okay, you got it. But I will say before, we're kind of wrapping up soon, but we do need to have...
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. We didn't even orchestrate this. I have no idea how we're going to do this. But
no, we're going to do it. Okay, so clap. Oh, we're going to sing.
Oh, don't worry. Don't you worry.
Don't you worry. Like, listen, you might be begging us to not sing it. No, it's going to be, we want you crying. But clap your hands if you like the game.
Seven up.
Heads up, seven up.
Yes, I forgot that we did plan it.
Talk about childhood, like.
Okay.
Again, when I, listen, I do want to say something about seven
your
up.
Your seven up trauma?
Yeah, my seven up trauma. It's like, everybody has, it's kind of like the same as kickball trauma. It's like being picked last. It's like, if my head is down and my thumb is up, if you're not pressing my thumb down, like, I don't want to be in that room. I don't.
Literally desperate for a thumb down and it's not happening.
Yeah.
And the worst part of that is, like, then you just, like, sit and watch. Like,
and you're like,
you don't get chosen. You're like, oh, I can watch you guys play a game.
Like, guess
while
who
I
it was?
Here.
It was literally
Everyone
Lindsay.
Everyone here hates me, but I'll watch you guys play 7-Up. Like, what was the point of that?
It's crazy.
I did love it, though.
Me too.
And we are going to play it. So
we're going to play it. So it's time for
the girls' room.
Okay. So,
if you want to ask us a question,
we're going to play Heads Up, Seven Up. So, what's going to happen is you're going to put your head down, you're going to put your thumb up, and we're going to come out and we're going to choose you. If we put your thumb down, you're going to ask the question. And any question is on the table.
Please make it easy. Please.
Please make it easy. Like, I can't be stressed. But yeah, so we're going to quickly play Heads Up, Seven Up. So if you do genuinely want to ask us a question, I think how many questions are we going to do?
I think we'll see.
Let's see. Let's see how many thumbs we choose.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to come down.
Okay, so heads down if you want to play.
Okay. Joe, I'm
going
to pick.
I'm going straight to. Okay, great. Excuse me. Oh my God, I knocked over a drink. Wait. I'm so sorry, I'll get you when you drink.
Okay. I picked my peeps. I'm gonna pick one more.
Wait, I'm also gonna pick another.
This is crazy. Okay. One second. Okay.
Okay. Okay, I'm coming back.
Okay.
Sorry.
All right. All right, guys, lift your heads, open your eyes. So if you got chosen.
I mean, yeah, I guess you guys should come up here.
You should come up. Right? Why not? I don't care. All right, we're going to start. Yeah, everybody come up.
Like, should everyone come up or should we do one at a time?
We'll do one at a time.
I'm so sorry that you're fully in center stage as I say it. Okay.
Listen, I didn't use that side as a napkin, only this. All right. Tell us your name.
Janella.
Queen.
We've met Janella before. She came to our Good Children meetup. What was that, like 3 months ago at this point? Two months ago?
Oh, no,
you
it was
us.
Not 1 month ago.
It was in October.
It was in October? And oh no, there's... And it's only
September.
November?
September.
September.
Don't even.
I was gonna say that couldn't have been a month. Like,
all right, Janella is a queen. Janella, ask us what question do you have for us?
My question is: F. Mary Kill, Ben Platt, Shawn Mendes, or Dr. Squatch?
Oh my God!
Okay,
not wait. Squatch.
Wait, not Dr. Squatch. Not Ben Platt. You had to throw it in there, and like I feel like Ben Platt, it would be so weird.
I was gonna say, I feel like I'm like, no matter what, I'm fucked here.
Yeah, it's because it's like
wherever I place Ben.
Listen, I will say quick. I know that the comments, is that Ben Platt? Is that Ben Platt? We went to Funny Girl.
Oh my God.
I'm walking in Funny Girl. The guy, he's like selling waters. He's like, hey, are you into theater? I'm like, I'm here. And he was like, has anybody ever told you that you look like Ben Platt?
And we were like,
and I'm
yes!
Like, yes, they do. Yeah, I want to be a Robert.
No, I love when people say it to you. I love when people say it to you like you've never heard it before.
Yes.
It's like my favorite way of it.
Yeah. All right, so back to Fuck, Marry, Kill, Ben Platt.
Shawn Mendes,
Dr. Squatch.
That's
okay,
such a good lineup.
That's honestly, I think I got it.
Okay.
I got it. Oh, should I go first?
Yeah, you can go first.
So I'm gonna kill. I'm gonna kill Ben Platt. And because I'm coming for you. No. No, I do love Ben Platt. I do love Ben Platt.
Wow.
I'm gonna have to kill Ben Platt in this situation. I'm gonna have to marry Shawn Mendes, and then listen, Dr. Squatch. Did you see him?
Yeah.
I'm gonna fuck Dr. Squatch.
I think, and I'm saying this out of service to Ben Platt, but also like I can only imagine the marriage would work out. Like, I'm marrying Ben Platt in this situation.
That makes sense.
I'm gonna fuck Dr. Squatch.
Yes.
Because we all know I'm in love with Bigfoot.
Why am I jealous?
And I'm killing Shawn Mendes. Okay. I'm so sorry.
All right. Thank you,
Janella. That was a great question. Queen.
All right.
Come on down.
Hi, what's your name?
Audrey.
How are we doing?
Okay, I'm gonna like pee my pants in like 2.5 seconds.
Oh, same. Because the whole time.
I literally was watching you guys say when I was working, I'm like, I got pregame tonight. All right, so this is a very specific question to Joe. So I used to work at BuzzFeed as my first job.
Oh my God, trauma bonded.
See, trauma.
Wait, trauma, literal trauma. What was your job at BuzzFeed and why did you leave?
Oh my God.
Yes, that's a good one, Audrey.
I feel like we're at like Comic-Con. Yeah. I was a video producer, but it was like not as fancy as I wanted it to be. I was actually working for the BuzzFeed parenting offshoot called Playful. So I was like downloading video content from like other parents, other parents like across the internet. I was like, hey, I love your diaper cake. Like, can I download this and share it across platforms? So it was like a lot of nothing for a long period of time. And then I, for a very brief moment, got promoted and was able to actually shoot content. And then like BuzzFeed's first big wave of layoffs happened. And they were like, you can stick around if you want. Because I was permalance. Wait, so were you working at the New York office?
Yeah.
Were we working together?
I quit in December.
Of 20...
21.
Oh, no. Okay.
You were gone.
I was, yeah.
It was after they did the IPO.
Oh,
was,
my God.
I did BuzzFeed shopping, and I was an Amazon advertiser, which was
Slay.
Not what I wanted to do.
Okay, a slay to me, honestly. Anything that wasn't my job was a slay to me. But yeah, they basically laid me off, but they were like, you can keep working. So I kept working for a little bit, and then I got a new job, and I was like, okay, I'm gone. But I would go back in a heartbeat.
I honestly do remember talking about your BuzzFeed. Like, honestly, I was pretending like I worked at BuzzFeed because I was like, Joe made it past the first round of layoffs. I was telling everybody at my office, being like, Joe made it. Don't even worry about Joe. You're like, who the fuck is Joe?
I remember you like communicating it. I feel like you and your friends were getting drinks, like being like, Joe didn't get laid off.
And then it was like, then it was a few days later, you're like,
yeah, they told me to go home.
Okay, I'm happy I got the drink when I did. Oh my God, but thank you, Audrey. Oh my God.
Great question. I love talking about me. Bye.
All right, our next queen. Oh my God, what is your name?
Daniela.
How's
it going?
How are you doing? Are you having fun?
I am.
Okay, good.
Thank God.
Because if you didn't say you were having fun, like, I don't know what would happen.
So my question is also for Joe.
Oh my God.
Yes, fuck me,
oh
you guys.
Oh my God.
I picked you.
I know you went to St. Anthony's, so who was your favorite teacher there?
Oh, my! These are like deep cut questions.
I love it.
I'm fully getting profiled. This is amazing. My favorite teacher at St. Anthony's High School had to be Mr. Kiernan, William Kiernan, my favorite English teacher.
He was going to come on the pod.
Yeah, we
and
were going to do
might.
Our first guests were going to be our favorite English teachers. Oh my God, who was your favorite?
Probably Miss Malangone.
I don't even know her.
Oh my God.
I don't even know if I know her. I like barely went. You know what I mean? Like I was there. Like
I think I went to St. Anthony's more than Joe went to St. Anthony's.
Andrew probably had
I was in the graduation video for St.
Yeah,
Anthony's.
And I wasn't.
I didn't even go there.
I was not featured and Andrew was in my graduation.
They were like, oh my God, it's Andrew. He went to St. Anthony's.
I will also shout out Lou Cordina, both Cordinas. I feel like they were like celebs there. We got to clap for the Cordina brothers.
They got some St. Anthony's.
They gave me my confidence. You know, that was really their moment. But yeah, I feel like it always comes back to English. I think we all can agree that like an English teacher is the pride and joy of a queer child's
it's
heart.
It's because it's the way that they use words. I'm like, oh my God, thank you for writing that on my paper. Like, I knew it was bad, but she was like, I see what you mean.
Yes.
Like, you see me? Okay, good. But I do think that like that's still coming up. I think that like
yeah, we want to bring them on
season two.
We're gonna do guests.
We're gonna do
on
guests
season
on
two.
Season two.
Yeah.
Do we feel good about? We feel good about that. But again, like the guests that we're gonna bring on are gonna make sense.
Yeah.
Bring our
moms. We didn't even invite our moms tonight. We said you guys can't come.
Yeah, we're like we don't. Know. That was me.
No, but like we needed it. Like they're gonna come to the next one.
They're gonna
we
come
just
to
like
all
couldn't.
Shows.
We couldn't handle it in this moment. We're good children.
We're good. Yeah. We're
we
like,
I wouldn't say
curse.
I wouldn't say fuck if they were here. It'd be a whole different show.
Oh. But yes, guest season two, and our English teachers will be them too. Yeah.
Thank you so much. Wait,
you.
So I'm sorry, don't leave yet. So you went to St. Anthony's.
When
did
you
graduate?
2019.
Oh my God, okay.
I graduated 2015.
Okay, so a year younger than me.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, thank you so much.
Oh my God,
thank you.
That's all we need to know. Thank you. All right. The next question can't be for Joe.
The next question is for Joe.
Nicholas. Nicholas! Oh my God, how are you doing?
I'm doing all right. How are you?
I mean, I'm doing great.
The tension?
Thank you.
There's a lot of tension on that couch.
Yeah, I'm like...
it's...
My question's for Joe. How is Royal feeling tonight?
This is
crazy.
I'm obsessed with this. This is Andrew's worst nightmare. Yeah. And this is Royal's dream come true. Like, actually. How do you know about Royal?
This was a plant.
Right.
Who planted?
Who planted?
Oh
my God. It's very secretive. Yeah. Royal's feeling amazing. This is literally what Royal wanted to do Royal's entire life, and now Royal's here. I also feel like I was wearing a tux for a lot of the Royal era, at multiple proms. So this is me in Royal drag. And he's back for one night only.
One night only.
Yeah.
I can't believe the people that I picked all had a question for Joe.
I fully
picked
Nicholas.
Did you pick Nicholas?
I picked Nicholas.
Oh my God. Whoops. Okay, bye Nicholas. Thank you. All right. Oh, listen, we got one more question for Joe, and it's.
Oh, fair.
Oh my God, absolutely. First of all, what's your name and what's your friend's name?
My name is Ella, and Kaya is...
Kaya.
Hi, Kaya. I get it.
I would be sick.
No, but... So we have kind of a mutual question for both of you. Don't worry.
Thank you so much.
So if you guys met, like, in your 20s or, like, later on in your life, not when you were little kids, do you think that you would still be friends? Like, you think that you would meet and, like, be friends?
We've thought about this a lot
really
recently.
Good question. Yeah.
What do you think?
I think that we would. I do think that we would be friends. I think that we're realizing, guys, that we're different. And it's just like it hit us after what 22 years that we're different.
Yeah.
No, I do think that we would still be friends. I think that like our interests, I mean, I it's hard because I feel like we've basically morphed
we have the same
into
DNA.
One being.
It's tough. Like, I think that, like, if I met you through a friend of a friend, I'd be like, I don't want to hang out with that person. And that's, like,
I would literally look at you and
my,
like
insecurity. No, but you're so confident. You know what I mean? Like, I'd be insecure around you. And I feel like that would make me instantly hate you.
Yeah.
But I do think if we got to know each other, we would be like, oh, we have really common interests, and, like, we get along.
Yeah.
I think it would take a longer while for us to get there.
It definitely would take a while, especially if, like, you were... Because I know, especially if you're, like, in a situation and somebody... You're you're not loving the vibe. It's a little bit more quiet, and I'm like, oh, he's out for blood. Yeah. He's pissed.
No, but it's just that I'm really shy.
I think we would get over it.
I think we get over it. I don't know who we'd be, though.
That's something that we also have a lot of conversations about. It's like, who would we be if we didn't know each other? Yeah.
Oh.
Cracking up at your mashed potatoes.
Do you want them?
Do you literally, like, my fist was genuine. No, my palm. It does look like snowballs. I might just tap it down a little bit so it's not as perky. But thank you.
Thank you so much. And thank you so much.
It was a great question, Kaya. All right, we got two more.
Okay.
And then
we gotta pick up the pace.
We're gonna pick up the pace because then we have 5 minutes.
Hello. Hi.
I'm
Emily.
Hi, Emily.
Nice to meet you.
We've DM'd before.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, you guys. She's bringing up my DMs. No, oh my god, I'm up.
Hi,
it's nice to see you in person.
So my question is, right now, Glee style mashup, what are you singing? And more importantly, what are you wearing?
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh, this makes me sick.
Oh my god.
Like, actually sick, because I'm not
I feel pretty unpretty, for sure.
If we were doing an actual Glee performance, easily.
Easily. I think that we both would, we would perform that together, right?
But I, yeah, oh yeah.
Obviously, this is the question.
Yeah, it's a mashup. Okay, we're doing it together, for sure.
And what would we, what do we want to wear?
If it's, did I hear cheerleading uniform? Yeah, I kind of would just
that or on my mom's favorite.
I would do, like, Rachel and Quinn drag fully for that performance. And I feel like Ryan Murphy would find a way to make that make sense.
Yeah.
You know, he'd be like, this is supposed to be happening in the halls of William McKinley. Like, I'm sure it has. I would also throw in Take Me or Leave Me, and I would mash that up with, like, something else, but I don't know what it is.
A Take Me or Leave Me would...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you so
much.
All right, thank
you. Thank you.
All right, I think that was the last question. So we are officially wrapping up. I know. I don't want to guys, but we do have a second show. So if you want to come to our second show, it's going to be a different conversation. But I will also say, like, another plug for merch. Merch is out the door. But before we leave, we do have an encore. So what's going to happen is we are going to leave this stage. And what we need to hear from you is encore.
Encore.
I like encore.
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 Okay. And, you know, it could be that dramatic. Like, again, pretend that you're fully at, like, a Taylor show. You're at a Beyonce show. Like, you're at a One Direction show. Like, all of the hit. A Meghan Trainor show.
And, again, it's going to be a power ballad. So...
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
You should have came up here and asked me a question. Enough of Joe. No, I'm kidding. No, if you know the song, we want you to sing along. We also want you to take your phones out, give us a little light.
Feel free to document.
Give us the whole moment, because I think that, like,
it might be a moment.
It might be a moment. So we're going to leave the stage.
Okay, so thank you guys so much.
Thank you so much, guys.
We're so sorry we have to go. You've been an amazing crowd, and we're walking off with Thanksgiving dinner plates.
Oh, my God.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
Thank you so much. We love you.
Oh, they're going nuts.
Yes.
Encore.
Encore. Encore. Encore.
Tom, encore.
Oh my god, they're stopping.
When was the last time that you felt America was fully unified?
Oh,
Kelly Clarkson. Right.
Hi, I'm Joe. I love this song. Oh, my Christmas list, oh, it's just so beautiful, you know? Like, everyone has a friend, boys you never start. Oh, it's just beautiful. Congratulations, Kelly Clarkson. You're a wonderful person. Oh, look, Kelly's here.
What if I told you it was all meant to be?
Would you believe me? Would you agree?
It's almost this feeling that we've met before. So tell me that you don't think I'm crazy when I tell you love has come here and now. A moment like this, some people wait a lifetime. For a moment like this, some people search forever for that one special kiss. Oh, I can't believe it's happening to me. Some people wait a lifetime for a moment like this.
My best friend is Andrew. We're exactly like each other always.
Everything changes, but beauty remains. Something so tender, I can't explain. Well, I may be dreaming, but till I awake, can we make this dream last forever? And I'll cherish all the love we shared. A moment like this, some people wait a lifetime. For a moment like this, some people search forever for that one special kiss. Oh, I can't believe it's happening to me. Some people for a moment like this. Some people wait a lifetime for a moment like this. Some people search forever for that one special kiss. Oh, I can't believe it's happening to me. Some people wait a lifetime for a moment.
You guys,
potato.
You just made our entire lives. You made our entire childhoods. Like, you
thank
made our
you.
Dreams come true.
Remember to be good.
Thank you to the Bell House.
Thank you to the Bell House.
Everyone in this room who made this happen. We could not be here without you. And we hope to see you in an hour for the next show.
Yeah.
So,
right.
Thank
have
you
a great night. Have a
so
happy Thanksgiving.
Much and good night.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye. Oh my God, this is it.